stupid, ain't he? Look who's talking. Get out.
Welcome back to the barn. We've had a lot of tools come to the studio over the years, but when it comes to welding hoods, we settle on three factors to decide if a helmet is right for us.
Number one, construction. How well is it made? Number two, fit and function. Is it comfortable? Does all the headgear work? And most importantly, number three, how does it perform? Is it safe? And does it work well? Okay, let's get the elephant out of the room, or the helmet in this case. Now, this thing looks great on paper, and we were very excited to go down to Harbor Freight and get it. We don't need an excuse to go down there. I like a lot of their tools. I use a lot of their tools. I think their titanium flux core welder 125 is one of the finest small flux core welding machines out there. I had a Portland chainsaw once that lasted for 6 years, and it was awesome. So I'm not here to poo-poo all over Harbor Freight. And the great thing is, there's always good staff. You can usually return anything to them, and you can probably pay a little extra and get a great extended warranty. But this helmet should not be costing $109. Even with a coupon, you could probably get it for $70 or so, and it's just not worth it. The construction's not great, and full disclosure, we dropped it one time in a week, and it broke beyond repair. So, I'm sorry to say, it went back to Harbor Freight, and yes, we got our money back. If you want to give it a try, I suggest you do. We're not going to waste your time here, and haters are going to hate, so sorry for that. It just doesn't stack up against these other $100 helmets. Look, you're already on YouTube, so go check out the endless amount of videos reviewing this helmet. We're just not going to do it.
Quit yanking our pieces, Freddy. What's the deal?
Now, back to our program.
Okay, let's get right in. And we're going to address number three first, because it's the most important. How do these helmets perform? You've got Lincoln on the left, YESWELDER on the right. Running 6013 rod, about 90 amps, 90 to 100, somewhere in there. Just a flat pass. And I'm going to let this run because I want you to just get a real clear sense of what you're seeing through the helmet. It was a very windy day. Conditions were poor at best, which kind of worked in our favor to make sure that you're seeing a real world viewing. Terminate that one real quick, and then we'll jump in here with some 7018, same settings. I'm going to speed this one up, but it's just to show you just how clear that Lincoln really is. And the YESWELDER has a great screen, and the True View, or True Color, whatever they call it, it looks nice. It's, you know, like daylight. But if you're wanting to see your weld, I think your option is clear here. We're running some flux core wire, 030, probably 75, 90 amps, somewhere in there. Here again, the YESWELDER is almost like daylight, but that good old green screen, it really lets you see the tip, see the puddle. Again, not the best day for welding. And some days, there are no ideal conditions. That's why you need a good helmet, right?
Breathe in. And breathe out.
Take a break for a moment.
Breathe in.
Rest those eyes.
A feeling of sheer peacefulness overtakes your whole.
We'll get back to the welding in a moment.
And more. Feel this loving, warm sensation. Feel very calm, very relaxed, and very, very peaceful.
Now on with the show, and you're going to need that break because keep an eye on the right for a moment. And I warn you, oh, there it goes. Got me. Oh, got me again. Okay, we're running 3/32nd rod, both tungsten and filler wire. I've got a variable pedal. It's probably set to 100 amps, but I don't think I'm running that hot. We're on 1/8 inch material, just doing some dabs. I think it's pretty clear here. Which one is a more consistent view? It's cleaner. I am not sure why that YESWELDER looks so grainy. Isn't that bizarre? Same camera, same settings, everything. Anyway, terminate the weld here. Now, I've got to forewarn you. And if you're susceptible to strobe lights, this may not be for you. Now, we had no intention of setting this to music. It just so happened that the radio was on in the background, and YESWELDER decided it was going to flare us with a beat. No, I'm not running pulse, and I'm running at full blast on that piece of metal. I'm pedal to the metal. I'm not changing the way that I weld at all. This is all due to the YESWELDER helmet. And you know, you can say, well, is it fully charged? Yeah, it's fully charged. We even tried 3 different batteries. I don't know what it is, but it's a problem. If you're a TIG welder, this just is not going to work for you. Yes, it had occurred to us that maybe this helmet was malfunctioning from the factory, so we reached out to YESWELDER. And after some back and forth, they offered us a full refund or a replacement helmet. So as far as customer service goes, we're going to give them 5 stars. Now let's get right in with number 1 and number 2, construction and fit and function. The YESWELDER helmet looks really nice. It's a decent helmet if you need to stick or flux core or MIG weld. And it looks good. I mean, look at it. It's cool, good design. The shell's a little flimsy, and as far as those Frankenstein knobs on the sides, they don't work great. Like, you kind of either get your hood up or your hood down, and nothing really in between. And that headgear, ugh. It looks nice. It's well-designed, but it's very small, and it's just kind of floppy flimsy. If you need to wear anything other than a welding cap, like us northern folk who need to wear winter hats, yeah, good luck. It's not a great fit. Let's jump in with the dials. They're nice. I like everything on the outside. I've said that before. And the cool thing about this helmet, it comes with a plasma cutting setting. So you get grind, cut, weld. The middle one's your shade. For welding, it goes from 9 to 13. That's pretty standard. I think for cutting, it's like a 8 through 10 maybe. And it works really well. I have to say, I pretty much only use this for plasma cutting now. The front's going to be your sensitivity, and the back is your delay. I'm just going to let these play. Go ahead and pause it if you want to read everything. These are the pros and cons, and take them seriously, because it's our final word on the matter. And then there was one. It's your tried-and-true Lincoln hood. Everything works on it. It's a pretty standard headgear. It's not the most comfortable, but it works well, and I think it'll last. There's your settings. Grind and weld, 1 and 2. That's all you get, folks. But that's all you need with this helmet, because it works great. There's not much more I can say about it. It's worth the money, and it'll last for years. And here's our final word on it. Again, go ahead and pause it if you like reading, and if it doesn't make your brain hurt. And then we'll wrap this up. And the winner is...
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Look, if you already own Lincoln products, and maybe you have this helmet, then you already knew this is probably how it was going to play out. But you never know until you try, right? You got to find the product that's right for you. We're just here to help out. We really appreciate you watching, and give us a like, subscribe, or leave a family-friendly comment down below. And you know, this piques my curiosity. I've been really enjoying this $50 helmet so much, I kind of wonder how it would stack up against this $100 helmet. Maybe next time, from Light of Fire Studio. Thank you for watching. Put on your best hoodie and go make something.
The end.